I've been asked for a reaction about some uncleanliness in the bow tie antenna story. This is the question, and it is unclear for this person what dimensions are correct. So he's talking about, he or she is talking about inches, and I don't think in inches, so I therefore calculated it to millimeters. So the width and the height is this in millimeters, and the frequency is 608 megahertz. It's mentioned here in the question. So the wave length is 493 millimeter. It's a high frequency. Then I calculated what half the frequency would be. That's of course half of this. And as a general rule of thumb, this antenna has a length, a total dipole length of about 0.7 of half a wavelength. So that's this. And when I calculate the wavelength with respect to the question, is it 528 millimeters as wavelength? And this will be the frequency. So in fact, when you make it this dimensions, you have a frequency of 567 megahertz, and we want to have it on 608 megahertz. Let's look what the calculator says. Looking at this calculator, online calculator, I will give the URL below in the comments, and you come to this screen, and we fill in here 608 megahertz, and of course I'm still thinking in millimeters, otherwise you can change to inches, but now for millimeters, and I say calculate, and then it is calculated. And then we see the total dipole length of 157 millimeter. So that is this total length. And that's a bit smaller than I had in mind. But let's see what MANA says about this. In MANA, I opened the 202 megahertz version I made before. And I positioned it already vertically, because the station is also vertically polarized. When I calculate, it says of course a very nice SWR, because I made this before. And then I go here to wire scale. This is the old frequency, this is the old frequency, and this is the new frequency, 608 megahertz. So that's the factor, and we say OK, and we have now the antenna for 608 megahertz. To find it out, we have here 608 megahertz, and when we calculate, start, it is excellent SWR. Far field plots, this and this, and when we look at it, the current distribution and the voltage distribution, it all looks fine. But what is now the dimension? And therefore we look at this top and this bottom. This is Z plus 0.08 meter, and this is minus 0.08 meter. So in total it's 16 centimeters large. 16 centimeter large for this antenna. So that's in line with what we had here, 157 millimeters. So I think that's good. Something about the dimensions. This wire length 0.083. This wire length 0.065, And we have here, wrong, and we have here the wire in between, the length 0.007. That are the dimensions. However, I don't know why we should make omnidirectional antenna if we want to have a station that is in one direction. So therefore, I'm going to make a reflector plate on this bow tie antenna. I did this already for my 202 megahertz version, and I cannot make a plate in MANA, so I made several vertical wires, vertical lines. These are the dimensions. And when we calculate now and we say start, it took some more time because I see a lot of reflector lines. The SWR is a bit up. If you look at the plots, we see that this shape now, it is no longer omnidirectional, but you have some gain in one direction. If you want to compare it with the one without the reflector plate, we can do it here. I compare and I load a file that I stored before, this one, and then you see the difference. This is the omnidirectional antenna, and this is the one if you add a small plate. So it is 40 dB more in the direction that is wanted. However, you could also choose a completely different approach and don't make a bow tie antenna, but make, for example, a double quad antenna. That has more gain, but it has, of course, a lot of directivity. But I think that's fine in this case, but maybe I'm wrong about it. Okay, hopefully this cleared this up. If you have more questions, please do not hesitate to ask. And of course, subscribe to my channel.